Patients who see a fertility specialist because of infertility or recurrent pregnancy loss can expect to undergo a bunch of tests to look for a cause or causes. There are some blood tests which are commonly missed, however, that may add a lot to your understanding of why you are having these problems. Which blood tests am I talking about? Stay tuned. Hi, I'm Dr. Randy Morris, MD. I am a board-certified fertility expert in the USA. When I review the medical records of new patients who have come to see me after having testing somewhere else, I commonly find some important tests that are missing from their evaluation. One of those is a blood test to look for antibodies to the bacteria Chlamydia. In the United States, about 1.5 million people will be diagnosed with Chlamydia each year. The real number of infections, however, is much higher because in most cases, infection with chlamydia does not cause any symptoms. Many infections are missed and therefore not treated. There is blood testing, however, that can identify people who have been exposed to chlamydia in the past. These blood tests identify antibodies that your body made in response to the infection. These blood tests suggest that 20 to 35% of the population has been exposed to chlamydia at some point during their lives, and in some groups, it could be as high as 70%. Chlamydia is transmitted through sexual intercourse. The bacteria can move from the vagina through the cervix and uterus and into the fallopian tubes. In the fallopian tubes, it can cause inflammation, which can result in the fallopian tube becoming blocked, which is an obvious cause for infertility. However, chlamydia can also damage the fallopian tubes, so that even if the tubes are not blocked, they do not function properly. This leads to infertility and tubal pregnancies. Women with chlamydia antibodies who also have elevated levels of a blood test for inflammation called hsCRP are most likely to have tubal disease or scarring. Chlamydia infection may also affect the uterine lining. So, could a past chlamydia infection also increase the risk for miscarriage? Recently, an analysis was done in couples with a history of one or two previous miscarriages who were enrolled in a study to determine if low-dose aspirin would reduce the risk for miscarriage. That study found that low-dose aspirin was effective in reducing the risk for miscarriage when their hsCRP was increased. These researchers found that the prevalence of pregnancy loss in the group with chlamydia antibodies was 43% compared to 21% in the antibody-negative group, more than twice as high a risk for miscarriage. The researchers tried to determine whether low-dose aspirin would reduce the risk for miscarriage specifically for the group that had elevated antibodies and an elevated hsCRP. Unfortunately, they did not have enough patients to be able to show a benefit. The trend was promising, however. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: women suffering from infertility or recurrent pregnancy loss should have blood testing to look at their hsCRP levels as well as for chlamydia antibodies. Close evaluation for tubal disease should be performed in people with abnormal levels. Even though precise data is lacking, starting low-dose aspirin is an easy, inexpensive, and low-risk treatment that may also be of benefit. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, IVF1.com, where you can become a patient.